In a shocking incident in Minneapolis, a 10-year-old boy drove a stolen car through a school playground, dangerously close to children engaged in play. The event unfolded on September 20th at Nellie Stone Johnson School and has left parents and community members in shock. Witnesses reported the terrifying sight of the vehicle speeding through the playground, with children narrowly avoiding a catastrophic encounter. This act raises grave concerns about the safety of children in public spaces and prompts questions about how a child so young managed to access a vehicle without anyone intervening. The boy has been arrested and is facing serious charges of second-degree assault. What makes this situation even more troubling is the child's extensive record, with over 30 prior entries detailing offenses that include auto theft and assault. Given this troubling history, many are left wondering how and why such young individuals find themselves repeatedly engaging in criminal behavior. The involvement of the family in the ongoing investigation adds another layer of complexity to the situation, signaling a pressing need for support and intervention. Minneapolis Police Chief Brian O'Hara has voiced the urgency of addressing such incidents, acknowledging the serious implications for community safety. His call to action emphasizes the necessity for programs that aim to deter young individuals from engaging in illegal activities. With a focus on prevention and rehabilitation, the community must work together to create safe environments for its children. Initiatives aimed at educating families about automobile safety and providing constructive alternatives to prevent youth from falling into crime are paramount. Furthermore, this incident serves as a stark reminder of the larger societal issues at play. When a child this young is involved in such perilous acts, it indicates underlying challenges within the community. Engaging with local organizations, schools, and families can foster stronger connections and support systems. Additionally, encouraging open dialogues about the dangers of auto theft and the repercussions it carries could help deter similar behavior in the future. As the investigation unfolds and charges are processed, the community must respond collectively. Addressing the root causes of youth crime is essential in preventing incidents like this from reoccurring, ultimately protecting not just the playground, but the childhoods of many.